A very good morning to you all, and let's begin with today's lecture, that is the rise of the Chinese economy. We are discussing alternative centers of power, powers which are rising so fast that in near future they can give a big challenge to America. We discussed ASEAN, we discussed the European Union, and in today's lecture we will be knowing about Chinese economy. China's economy is growing so fast that in 2040, it is expected. Since 1978, after the reforms which China applied towards their economic strategies, whatever plannings they executed, as a result of that, the speed, the acceleration with which China's economy is growing, it is expected that they will take over America till the year 2040. China's economic growth makes it a very powerful player on international platform, but other than the acceleration, other than the speed of its growing, speed of the growth of Chinese economy, there are certain other factors, there are certain other dimensions which make China a very powerful country on international platform, and they are China's huge population, a very good quality of human resource, and of course the most populated country in the world. Its vast resources, natural resources, regional location, and political influence. China's location in Asia is a very crucial and a very important one. Its political influence is growing so fast, power is growing so fast, that it is expected that China can take over. So far the title of hegemon is concerned, it might be expected that China can take over America. But the kind of position, the kind of powerful status which China is having right now, and role which is played only and in its power, which is totally played by its economic growth, was not so. When we talk about the past, things were not so. China's economy was not so powerful in the beginning. In 1949, there was the inception of People's Republic of China, the only political party which China has till the date. It was a party which was influenced by the communistic ideas of Mao, and they decided to keep a distance from the capitalistic ideology of the West, and they decided to take more help from the USSR. It was a country which wanted to create an economy, which wanted to develop an economy which would be totally, all the resources and decision making capacity will be concentrated in the state. It was a country which wanted to make a centralized economy, and whatever they would be, but of course they lacked foreign exchange to buy technology. They lacked currency, they lacked capital for industrial growth. And that is the reason they decided to invest more in agriculture. Whatever they would be earning as a result of agricultural growth, they would be investing it in their foreign exchange. They would be investing it in buying technology for their industrial growth. And that was their planning. It was a country at that time in 50s, they decided not to go for any kind of foreign exchange, any kind of foreign investment. It was a country in 1950s which they decided, but things changed. There were certain reasons for which China had to go for certain amendments in their plannings. The biggest reason was that no doubt China was growing, and China was able to get the respectable per capita growth of 5 to 6% per annual, like percent annual growth of GDP, and basic facilities were provided to the public. But of course, still at that time, things were not satisfactory. They were not able to catch the economic growth of the West. They were not able to go for buying foreign technology still, because they lacked foreign exchange. It was not in abundance at the time. Because whatever they earned as a result of agriculture and investment, it was used in feeding their own population. Their capital was not left for industrial growth. And that is the reason China had to take certain decisions. China had to come out of the shell of that that communistic approach, the communist state concentrated economic approach, which changed the scenario, which we will be discussing in my next lecture. Thank you.